Here's the kidney model. Three layers, levels. First level is the kidney itself. You have on the outside the renal capsule. The light layer of tissue on the outer area is the renal cortex. Each one of these little triangular shaped darker colors, each one is a renal pyramid ending in a papilla. All the pyramids together equal the renal medulla. So one triangle is a renal pyramid, all the triangles together renal medulla. Each renal pyramid ends in a renal papilla. The light tissue, the cortex, renal cortex, also pushes inward. So these little areas are renal columns. So this light tissue here is a renal column, here's a renal column. The space here, that structure is going in and out of the kidney, is the hilum. Each renal pyramid fits into a minor calyx. So here's a minor calyx, there's a minor calyx, there's a minor calyx. The minor calyxes fuse to form a major calyx. So here's a major calyx, here's a major calyx. They fuse to form the renal pelvis. And the renal pelvis turns into the ureter. We have a lot of blood vessels here. We have the renal artery and vein. Renal artery becomes segmental artery, which becomes interlobar artery between the pyramids. Interlobar artery then becomes the arcuate artery, arcing over the pyramid. And then when it goes into the cortex, it's the cortical radiate artery. Vein, same name, opposite direction. So cortical radiate vein, arcuate vein, interlobar vein, and renal vein. Come over to this section. Here, of course, is part of a renal pyramid, part of the renal cortex. Here is the interlobar artery and vein, arcuate artery and vein, corticoradiate artery, corticoradiate vein. Where they come together here would be peritubular capillaries. We also can see here that these spheres are globular capsules. If you cut them open, that little space in the middle is the glomerulus. This entire structure here is a nephron. Here is another nephron. Each nephron, of course, has the glomerular capsule going to the proximal convoluted tubule, the descending limb of the nephron loop, the ascending limb of the nephron loop, the distal convoluted tubule, which then becomes the collecting duct, which leads to the papilla of the pyramid. Over here is a close-up of the glomerular capsule. So here's the glomerular capsule. Here's the glomerulus inside the glomerular capsule. Here's the afferent arteriole bringing blood in. Here's the efferent arteriole exiting with blood. And this here is the proximal convoluted tubule.